So in the last lecture, we have seen India's achievement in the areas of science and technology. Okay, and we have also seen important institutions of science like Indian Atomic Energy Commission, and we have seen nuclear tests, also missile developments. Okay, now we will see about space research. So in 1961, Indian National Committee for Space Research, NCSR, okay, Indian National Committee for Space Research, NCSR, launched India's first research rocket from Thumba Equatorial Launch Center in Thumba in the state of Kerala. Okay, in state of Kerala, there is a rocket launch center, that is Thumba Equatorial Launch Center. Okay, so in 1961, it was established by Indian National Committee for Space Research, NCSR. You can see the picture, Thumba Equatorial Rocket Launching Station. Okay, it's the old picture. So, as India has tested nuclear, developed missiles also, then National Committee for Space Research. Now, India's achievement in space we are seeing. Okay, so India is successfully established National Committee for Space Research, NCSR, at Thumba Equatorial Launch Center in Kerala. So in 1969, our indigenously built rocket Rohini, you can see in the picture, name of the rocket is Rocket Rohini 75. Okay. In 1969, our indigenously built rocket Rohini 75 was successfully launched. Okay, so it indigenously built means it was built in India only. Okay, in 1969, our indigenously built rocket Rohini 75 was successfully launched. The next stage was the successful launch of the first Indian satellite Aryabhatta in 1975 with the help from the Soviet Russia. Now in 1969, Rohini 75, okay, was successfully launched, and next was Indian satellite, first Indian satellite Aryabhatta, and it was built with the help of, from Soviet Russia. Rohini 75 was built in India only, but satellite Aryabhatta was built with the help from Soviet Russia. You can see in the picture Aryabhatta satellite. This success proved that scientists can indigenously build and launch a satellite. Okay. So after launching rocket, after launching satellite also, now this proved that Indian scientists can indigenously build and launch a satellite in India. Okay. Indian scientists were confident that they could acquire the technology for sending a message from the Earth station and to assess the working of the satellite. In the picture, you can see Earth station. Okay, from here messages are sent to satellite. Okay, and working of the satellite is done. Access of satellite is done from Earth station. So now Indian scientists are confident that they could acquire the technology for sending a message from the Earth station and to assess the working of satellite. Working of satellite is operated and accessed from this Earth station. The picture is about Earth station. So this was about space research. Now, Indian Space Research Organization, okay, ISRO, ISRO. The full form of ISRO is Indian Space Research Organization. That is ISRO. After the success of the basic program in the space research, okay, now India succeeded in launching a rocket and satellite. Then after the success of space program, space research program, after the success of the basic program in space research and rocket related project, Indian Space Research Organization was established. ISRO was established on 15th August 1969. In order to carry out further space research. Okay. So what was this objective? To carry out the further space research. The headquarters of ISRO, ISRO, that is Indian Space Research Organization, are at Bangalore. And ISRO activated the space station at Sriharikota, that is in Andhra Pradesh, for launching our satellites in space. From here, satellites are launched in space, and the space station is at Sriharikota. It is in Andhra Pradesh. Bhaskar 1, India launched remote sensing experimental satellite Bhaskar 1. Bhaskar 1 is the name of the satellite. It's remote sensing satellite, okay. India launched remote sensing experimental satellite Bhaskar 1 from the Soviet Russia in 1979 in order to observe various things on the surface of the Earth. Why it was launched? To observe various things on the Earth by remote sensing technology. With the help of remote sensing technology, various things on the surface of Earth can be minutely observed. Okay, and this satellite was launched from Russia, Soviet Russia, in 1979. This remote sensing technology would be useful for India's development. Okay, so the use of this technology is for India's development regarding water bodies, mineral deposits, and forecasting weather. So this remote sensing technology would be useful for India's development by regarding water bodies, like searching where are water bodies, mineral deposits, okay, with the help of satellite where mineral deposits are, from where it can be obtained, and forecasting the weather. Okay, so weather forecast is done through satellites. So with the help of this remote sensing technology, in the fields of water bodies, mineral deposits, and forecasting weather, it would be very useful. The photographs taken with the help of this technology about the bowels of the earth, environment, and forests were important. With the help of the satellite, the photographs which were taken, okay, from about the bowels of the earth, environment, bowels of the earth means from the inside of the earth, okay, and environment and forests were important. Okay, this is a picture of Bhaskar 1 satellite. Another area in which the information from the satellite was useful for oceanography, for studying oceanography, this information gathered from satellite was very useful. So with the help of satellite, India can develop, or India can progress, okay, in many fields. In 1981, Bhaskar 2 was launched from Soviet Russia. Again, Bhaskar 1 was launched in 1979, and in 1981, Bhaskar 2 was launched from Soviet Russia. You can see the picture of satellite. This is Bhaskar 2. And it was launched in 1981 from Soviet Russia. Okay. Next is APPLE, Apple. Ariane Passenger Payload Experiment. Okay. APPLE, that is Apple, Ariane Passenger Payload Experiment. Okay, let's see what is this. This is a picture of apple. The first completely indigenously built satellite by ISRO in India. Okay, this satellite is indigenously built satellite by ISRO in India. This is made in India. Okay, this satellite is made in India completely by ISRO in India. Apple was launched on 19 June 1981 from the French Guiana. Okay, so in the year 1981, it was launched from French Guiana. Apple was beneficial in the field of education. Okay, so the purpose of this was it will help in field of education. The objective of providing emergency telecommunication services was successful. To provide emergency telecommunication, the satellite service was very useful and successful. Next is Indian National Satellite, INSAT. INSAT, Indian National Satellite. Okay, you can see the picture of the satellite. In August 1983, the satellite INSAT-1B, INSAT-1B, was launched in space. Because of this satellite, a major revolution came about in the areas of telecommunication, television, radio, weather forecasting, and space research in India. Okay, because of this satellite, there was major revolution, major development can be seen in the areas of telecommunication, okay, and television, radio, weather forecasting, and space research in India. Due to INSAT, 207 Akashvani or radio stations could be connected to each other. Because of this satellite, various radio stations like 207 Akashvani, 207 Akashvani or radio stations could be connected. This was possible because of INSAT satellite. This mechanism was also useful for search and rescue of people. Okay, now this satellite is helpful in searching and rescuing the people if disaster like shipwreck or an airplane crash. Okay, for forecasting weather, to look for and follow cyclones or storms. In the fields of telemedicine and educational institutions, if some disaster happens like shipwreck in ocean or aeroplane crashes, okay, so this satellite is helpful for searching and finding them, okay, their location. Then for forecasting weather, for weather forecasting, weather can be forecasted, predicted, okay, with the help of this satellite. The satellite shows the proper weather related things. To look for and follow cyclones or storms, if cyclone or storm is going to take place, okay, it gives signals and it tells us. In the field of telemedicine and educational institution, in educational system also and in telemedicine, this satellite is very, very helpful. Now let's see what is the telemedicine. The telemedicine service enables the population from remote areas to get advice and treatment from expert doctors. In the picture, you can see a doctor is consulting a patient online, okay? That is called telemedicine. They are having conversation, okay? Patient is talking to the doctor. Public primary health centers in village have been connected with super specialty hospitals through INSAT. Okay, INSAT, that satellite has connected super specialty hospitals with villages. Okay, in village there are public primary health center. Okay, there are not so super specialty or big hospitals. So this satellite has connected primary public health center from villages to super specialty hospitals in big cities. So this satellite INSAT was beneficial for the development of India. Now we will see some technological progress. This is a picture of factory manufacturing railway engines. You can see work is going on for the locomotive engine. Now in the field of technology, what progress India has done, we will see technological progress. A factory manufacturing railway engines, Chittaranjan Locomotive Works. Okay, this is the place Chittaranjan in Burdwan district in West Bengal. Here a factory where railway locomotive engines are manufactured. Okay, this was set up in West Bengal. Steam engines, electric engines and engines running on diesel were manufactured here. Okay, so engines which run on steam, electric engines and engines running on diesel were manufactured here. They were built over here. The first diesel engine was manufactured at the diesel locomotive works at Varanasi. Okay, so this, there is a factory in West Bengal also, the Chittaranjan Locomotive Works, and then diesel locomotive works at Varanasi. Okay, India started manufacturing railway locomotive engines. Then India started exporting railway engines to Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Tanzania and Vietnam. Okay, after manufacturing locomotive engines over here, India started providing railway engines to Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Tanzania and Vietnam. So this was a technological progress. Next is telex service. Now what is telex service? You can see the picture. Telex provides a means of printed communication using teleprinter. Okay, this is a device where printed communication happens. Okay, message is typed on this, printed on this. Okay, using teleprinter. This is a teleprinter. So before like phones or mobiles or internet, so first communication was done through this telex service. Okay. The Department of Telecommunications under the Ministry of Communications started the telex services in 1963 to transmit typed messages from one part of the country to another rapidly. Okay. Now we have mobiles, internets, okay? So we can quickly pass our messages, okay, from one country to another country. But in 1963, the Department of Telecommunications, okay, they started the telex service to transmit type messages from one part of the country to another rapidly. So from here, a printed message can be sent from one country to another country, from India to other countries. In 1969, the telex service started in Devanagari script in Delhi. Okay, So after the 3 years of this telex service in 1969, Devanagari script was started in Delhi. Later, it spread all over the country. This service began to be used in different fields, okay? For sending messages of different fields also, this service began to be used. With the rise of internet after 1990, the significance of this service was reduced. So when in 1990, internet use was introduced, so the use of telex service was reduced. So before internet, telex service was used for sending typed messages from one country to another country. Later on in India also it started within the country. Then after the rise of 1990, after the rise of internet, the use of telex service was reduced. Next is Satellite Communication Center. You can see in the picture, this is Satellite Communication Center, okay? To get access over the satellite, to give messages, to work on satellite, to operate on satellite, that Satellite Communication Center was established. Let's see about Satellite Communication Center. In order to establish satellite communication with the help of an artificial satellite, a domestic satellite communication Earth station was established in 1967 at Jodhpur Tekra near Ahmedabad. Okay, so at Jodhpur Tekra near Ahmedabad, this satellite station was established in the year 1967 to communicate from the Earth station. Okay, in India, the station was established to communicate through satellite. This made it easy to train scientists and technicians in setting up and running an Earth station within the country. Okay, now this station helped to train scientists and technicians how to run Earth station, how to operate Earth station, how to communicate with that Earth station within India only. Okay, that's why this Satellite Communication Center was established. In 1970, a center was established at RV near Pune, equipped for international telecommunication service. So in 1970, a center at Pune, that is RV near Pune, was established for the purpose was to establish international telecommunication services. With the help of this satellite, international telecommunication could take place. So the next picture is of PIN code. You can see what is PIN code. A correct address with PIN code enables the post to reach addressee promptly. Okay, when you are giving your when you are writing letter, when you are sending or posting letter, you write the PIN code first. You write the address and at the end you write PIN code. Some number is there. Okay, you write it. Now, why it is written? What is the use? When it was started? Okay, what was the objective behind it? We will see. So, when if you write PIN code of the area, okay. So that letter or that parcel, that courier reaches correctly to the person on the correct address. So from 15 August 1972, the Post and Telegraph Department started the 6-digit PIN code system in the country. There are six numbers in a PIN code. For Maharashtra, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44 are the first two digits. You can see over here, there are 6 digits. Okay. And in Maharashtra, first two digits are of 40, 41, 42, 43, and 44. Now, how to decode this? Okay, how to know which area's pin code is this? So, first digit will tell you about region in India. Second digit will tell you sub-region. Third will be district. Okay, and last three digits will tell you the post office, okay, from where it belongs. The first digit of the pin code indicates the region, the second indicates the sub-region, the third digit shows the main disbursement district, okay, third digit shows the main district, while the remaining three digits show the location of the local post office. So in this way, pin code is decoded. If you write the correct pin code of an area, your letter, your courier, your parcels will reach properly. In 1986, the speed post service was started to send postage rapidly. In the picture, you can see speed post. Here, this service was started to send postage or letters or parcels, couriers within less time. Okay. The postal index code is intended to bring efficiency in distributing the mail. Okay. Next is International Subscriber Dialing Telephone Service, ISD. You have read this word, okay? ISD, PCO, and telephone, on telephone booth, right? ISD. ISD stands for International Subscriber Dialing Telephone Service. International Subscriber Dialing, ISD. In 1972, Overseas Communication Service was established in Mumbai for the management of international telecommunication service. Overseas Communication Service was established in Mumbai, okay, for getting connected with other countries, okay, getting connected with foreign countries. So international telecommunication service was established. In 1976, the International Subscriber Dial Telephone, ISD, okay, telephone service was started to connect Mumbai and London directly on phone. We have seen telex service there where typed messages was sent, okay, in 1963, 1969 we have seen. Now in 1972, ISD was established to communicate with other countries, foreign countries, right? So now first telephonic communication center, okay, ISD, was started to connect Mumbai and London directly on phone. Alongside the telephone services like telex, teleprinter, and radio images were started. Services like telex, teleprinter, radio images were also started. In 1986, Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited, VSNL, took a big leap in this field. Before that, Mahanagar Telephone Nigam Limited, MTNL, was a public sector company for giving telephone services in big cities. So MTNL, this was a public sector company which gave telephone services in big cities. big cities. From the name itself, you can understand Mahanagar, okay? Big cities, telephone service. So MTNL gave telephone services in big cities. In the 1990s, Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited, okay, held the distinction of being the main internet service provider in India. Videsh, okay, Videsh means foreign. Channel throughout the India. Now we have different service providers of internet, like, okay, but in 1990s VSNL Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited provided internet services in India. The contribution of Sam Pitroda in this field is significant. Can see the picture. Sam Pitroda is the engineer in telecommunication. Okay, so his contribution in the field of telecommunication was significant, was very, very important. The contribution of Sam Pitroda in the field of telecommunication was very significant. Now, after telephone service and internet service, we will see about mobile. On 22nd August 1994, the mobile phone service started in India. Okay. So, first mobile phone service began on 22nd August in the year 1994. At this time, a mobile handset cost ₹45,000 and calling was at ₹17 per minute. Okay? So this was the first mobile handset where the cost, initial cost was ₹45,000 and calling rate. Okay? So per call, the price of the per call was ₹17 per minute. By 1990, many private companies came in this field. This made the service cheaper. Now we have n number of mobile companies which provide mobile services at cheaper rate, cheaper price, calling also, internet service also at cheaper price, okay? And mobile handsets also are affordable now because of many private companies came into the field of mobile service. So we have seen India's, we are seeing India's journey from telex service to communication. Okay. Now after mobile, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, BSNL. You must be knowing, you have known this word, right? BSNL. Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, BSNL. In the year 2000, the telecommunication department was restructured, okay? Again, this telecommunication department was restructured. The responsibility to make policy decisions was retained with the telecom department, and Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited was established to actually provide the services to consumers. Along with the telephone service, now which services was provided by BSNL? Along with the telephone service, cellular phone, internet, broadband services were also made available. Okay, so in the year 2000, the telecommunication department was restructured to provide facilities to the consumers, okay, like telephone service, cellular phone means mobile phone, internet facility, broadband services, etc. These were made available by BSNL. Oil and Natural Gas Commission, ONGC. In 1956, the Oil and Natural Gas Commission was established to search for the deposits of mineral oil and natural gas and to increase their production after. Okay. So in the year 1956, ONGC, that is Oil and Natural Gas Commission, was established. Okay. The purpose behind this for searching the deposits of mineral oil. So like mineral oil, natural gas are obtained from the earth. Okay. So these deposits were established to obtain mineral oil and natural gas and to increase their production. You can see in the picture. Natural Gas Commission. Oil and Natural Gas Commission. Okay. After Digboi in Assam, mineral oil deposits were found in Ankleshwar area in Gujarat. Later, mineral oil and natural gas deposits were found in the Gulf of Khambat in Gujarat. In 1974, the Oil and Natural Gas Commission started digging an oil well in Bombay High area with the help of Russian scientists by a drill ship called Sagar Samrat. Okay? So with the help of Russian scientists in the sea, with the help of drill ship, digging of oil was started in 1974 to dig an oil well in Bombay High area with the help of Russian scientists. Okay. You can see in the picture, there is a drill ship in the sea. It is drilling an oil well, Okay. To extract oil from the well. The name of this drill ship is Sagar Samrat. From 1975, mineral oil and natural gas began to be extracted from there. Later, more than 8,500 oil wells and 33 natural gas wells dug eventually in this area began to contribute 38% of the total mineral oil production in the country. Okay, from here, so many wells, like 8,500 oil wells, 33 natural gas wells was dug, and the contribution of oil production and gas was 38% in the country and met 14% of the country's demand for crude oil. Okay, from the India's demand was fulfilled from 14% from here. Next is railways and technology. Okay, progress of India in the fields of railways and technologies. The technology adopted by railways has a big role in the history of modern India. Okay, there is a big role of India in the history of railways. In order to bring efficiency, accuracy and coordination in the reservation system in rail travel, computerized reservation system was started for the first time in Delhi in 1984. Okay. So for traveling, for going from one place to another place by train, we have to reserve tickets. Now we see the printed and reserve tickets, right? So this was first reservation, computerized reservation was first started in Delhi in the year 1984. Okay, why this was started? To bring order, to bring efficiency and accuracy and coordination in the reservation system. Okay, so through computerized system, records were maintained. Okay, was easy also for booking tickets. In the same year, the metro was started in Kolkata. So you can see the picture of first metro train in Kolkata. In this way, India has been making progress in the fields of science and technology. New inventions have been made. India is an important 21st century nation which has always used technology for establishing peace in the world. Okay? What about technologies India is using? Has always used for peaceful purpose. Okay? India is making all these advancements in order to be the foremost among nations in the 21st century. In the next chapter, we shall learn about the progress of India in the fields of commerce and trade. Okay? So in this chapter, we have seen India's progress in the field of science and technology. We'll have a look, we'll see points to remember, some important points. Establishment of Indian Atomic Energy Commission was established on 10th August 1948 by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. First chairman of the Indian Atomic Energy Commission was Dr. Homi Bhabha. Objectives of the commission was to produce electricity from atomic energy, to increase the yield of food grains and develop nanotechnology. Nuclear reactor set up by the Department of Atomic Energy was Apsara in 1656. Establishment of atomic power station at Tarapur, 1969. Nuclear reactor set up by the Department of Atomic Energy was Apsara in the year 1956. There is a printing mistake. It should be 1956, not 1656. Okay. So Apsara was a nuclear reactor was set up in 1956. Establishment of an atomic power station at Tarapur, 1969, reactor research center using thorium for generating atomic power was established at Kalpakkam, Tamil Nadu. Institution for manufacturing heavy water board. Science Day, 28 February. 28 February is celebrated all over the country as Science Day. Indian made nuclear reactor on 28 February, and nuclear reactor that uses uranium as fuel is Dhruva 1985. Dhruva established in 1985. company set up to generate electricity from atomic energy, that is Nuclear Power Corporation of India, NPCIL. India's first nuclear test, 18th May 1974, Pokhran in Rajasthan. India's second nuclear test, 11th May 1998. India tested the Prithvi missile, 11th May 1998. Okay, I think time is up and we will continue the question answers and important points in the next lecture. Hello, sir.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yes, sir.